It is safe to say that these are not good times for BC ferries. A crash has knocked out a major terminal on the island for months. Ships are breaking down. Even the weather won't cooperate with the schedule. Now the ferries commissioner has released a report that looks for a way that the fleet can ride out its overarching problems: rising fares, declining ridership, and losses in the millions. He is not suggesting a rollback of ferry fares, but suggests moving away from a user pay system with some service cuts, more government subsidies, and even mandatory reservations. CTV's Stephen Andrew reports.
The sting at the toll booth has become too much for BC Ferry passengers.
The Washington State Ferry that I took in the summer, three of us were in the car, and she said, $14, please. And I said, what? $114, what? $14, please, for the car and three of us. And we come back over here, and the same scenario, 90.
And BC's ferry commissioner is also acknowledging fares have reached a tipping point.
Over the last 9 years, fares have gone up by 47% on the major routes and 80% on the minor routes.
But with passenger loads continuing to drop, multi-billion dollar capital projects on the horizon, and a corporation set to lose millions of dollars this year and beyond, the commissioner says something needs to be done.
I do think it can be turned around. To me, there's two parts to it. It's trying to set the price caps at an affordable level, but also to give people enough confidence about what they're going to be in order to make long-term decisions about investing in businesses or in homes. And so we're trying to incorporate both of those ideas.
In a sweeping review of the ferry system released today, the commissioner is recommending moving away from the current user-pay model laid out by the BC Liberal government in 2003. Among the commissioner's other recommendations, more oversight of capital plans, an increase in government subsidies, and tying future fare price caps to inflation. The transportation minister promises to review the report, but is not offering more money just yet.
Obviously, we have heard loud and clear that there's a concern from British Columbians on the sustainability and affordability of this system. That's why the work has been done to this point, and I'm looking forward to finding the solution that works for all of us.
BC Ferries welcomes the report and is also looking to the government for help.
We're going to need some help over the long term to solve this problem, and that's looking at reasonable service levels for the communities, making sure the ships are there when they need them, but not running them when they don't need them, and asking the government to look at the service levels and the subsidies that they provide, because we're going to need some help in that area as well.
The ferry commissioner is also recommending moving to a system where every passenger requires a reservation but not have to pay the reservation fee. The commissioner believes BC Ferries could then manage its fleet more effectively and save money. Passengers we spoke to at Swartz Bay this afternoon like the idea, but BC Ferries isn't that enthusiastic. The company says it will take more than a year to set up the system, and it will need to find a replacement for the $15 million annual revenue from its current reservation and assured loading system.
Stephen Andrew joins us now live with more on the story. Stephen, this is a very large report, sweeping, 90 pages in length, trying to deal with some pretty significant problems. So if the government's going to respond to some of these recommendations, how soon will that happen?
Well, the transport minister told us today that he needs to go through that report and then consult with government. So it's doubtful we're going to hear anything before the budget. In fact, it could take several months. But with the losses mounting, Hudson, and the government cannot take too long, the NDP is already criticizing the government's handling of BC Ferries. So watch for that pressure to increase when the legislature resumes next month.
And when you lay out the increase in the fares, as the commissioner did today, 47% in 9 years.
Yeah, it's huge. But they say, and BC Ferries explained this today as well, that they're sitting in the middle of the pack. Certainly they're not low, say, as the Alaska system, but they're certainly sitting in the middle of the pack. They figure that you're getting good value for money. But still, as we heard from passengers today, they're really holding back on trips, and they say it's just too much now.
All right, Stephen Andrew reporting. Stephen, thanks.
You're welcome.